Well, good morning, everyone. My name is David Wicks. I'm Vice President of the Nasdaq OMX Group, and it is truly my great pleasure to welcome Meals on Wheels Association of America and its President and CEO, Ellie Hollander, as well as all our other distinguished guests. Now, we have two sets of distinguished guests. We have distinguished guests over here. Where are you all from? New York.
Mexico.
New York and Mexico. And then, so have you guys ever heard of something called Wix.com? No? All right, you got to check it out. W-I-X, not like David Wicks. But also our friends Wix.com are visiting us here, and they're a company based in Israel. So I want to extend a warm welcome to all of you. We're excited that you could all join us right here from the crossroads of the world in Times Square, New York, as we get set to officially ring the Nasdaq opening bell. Now, I know there's a lot to be thankful for. I like to start each ceremony with a big round of applause. I'm still convinced the more we clap, although I'm looking at the futures and might be tough this morning. But the more we clap, the less the market will go down. So let's give a round of applause and kick things off. The Meals on Wheels Association of America is the oldest and largest national organization composed of and representing local community-based senior nutrition programs in all 50 U.S. states, as well as all U.S. territories. All told, there are some 5,000 local senior nutrition programs in the U.S. These programs provide well over 1 million meals to seniors who need them each day. Some programs serve meals at congregate locations like senior centers. Some programs deliver meals directly to the homes of seniors whose mobility is limited. And many programs provide both services. While remarkable, the 1 million meals per day figure really underestimates the size and shape of the network and its reach and influence in communities across America. In addition to the hundreds of thousands of seniors who receive meals, there are many thousands of professionals employed at the various local senior nutrition programs across the U.S. More notable than that is that the virtual army of volunteers who also work for these programs. It is said that this group, numbering between 800,000 and 1.7 million individuals, is the largest volunteer army in the nation. Ellie, thanks to you and the entire Meals on Wheels team for your support. We were talking, so two quick things. One, the program provided my grandparents help when they were not able to go out, so thank you for that, but also, you know, we talked this morning a little bit about the sequester. So, you know, programs like Meals on Wheels are directly being impacted, and that impacts their ability to get meals to our seniors, to people who can't go out. So it's very important that we support organizations like this, and we really hope that today's market open brings more awareness to all of their meaningful and critical work that they do. Now, it is my pleasure, and please join me in welcoming Ellie Hollander, President and CEO.
Thank you. I think it's really fitting for me to be speaking here today at Nasdaq's opening bell ceremony, surrounded by people who are investing in the future of America. That's because, contrary to what you might think, Meals on Wheels is precisely the type of investment that we should be making. Meals on Wheels generates a very high return on investment by helping seniors to avoid far more expensive healthcare alternatives, saving taxpayers millions of dollars in Medicaid and Medicare expenses. In fact, Meals on Wheels can feed a senior for an entire year for what it costs to be in the hospital for one day. But don't just take my word for it. A recent study by the Center for Effective Government showed that for every $1 invested in Meals on Wheels, there is a $50 savings in Medicaid alone. Every day, our programs are serving in excess of 1 million meals to our nation's most isolated, frail, and unhealthy seniors. Sometimes, the Meals on Wheels volunteer is the only person that that senior will see in an entire day. For these homebound and hungry seniors, Meals on Wheels is their lifeline. So it's perplexing to me why, in the richest country of the world, We have 1 in 7 seniors, or 8.3 million, struggling with hunger today. Amazingly, though, this is a problem for which we have proven and effective solutions, Meals on Wheels. But due to the sequester, as David mentioned, $48 million in federal funding is being slashed from Meals on Wheels programs versus investing in them, shifting a huge financial and social burden to future generations as our population continues to age. 50 years ago, President John F. Kennedy proclaimed May as Older Americans Month. And as we ring the bell today, let's remember our parents, our grandparents, our uncles and aunts, our teachers, our military veterans, and scores of others to whom we pay tribute this month for the invaluable and everlasting contributions they've made to enriching life in America. And in their honor, for goodness sakes, let's put an end to senior hunger. Thank you.